Hello viewers, today we are going to talk about tie-dye textiles of India. Have you heard about Patolas, Pochampally Ikats and Telia Rumals? No? Then today we are going to talk about all of these. By the end of this session, you will have some understanding about Patolas, Telia Rumals and Pochampally fabrics. India is home for all of these textiles. The designs and the weave that are specific to these textiles differ from one region to another region. The exquisite and intricate recess dyed ikats and tie-dyed fabrics can be traced back to the 6th or 7th century fresco paintings of Ajanta caves and also excavations from Mohenjo-daro and Harappa. The word ikat per se is derived from Maya Indonesian word called mungikat, which means bind or knot. This is a recess technique. The yarns are tied in a specific pattern as envisaged by the master weaver. Once tie-dyeing is done, the yarns are taken to the loom and then weaving takes place. The characteristic feature of these tie-dye textiles of India is the hazy pattern which you can see on the fabric. This hazy pattern is because of the tie-dye yarns that are used in weaving. There are three different types of ikat: single ikat, double ikat and combined ikat. Single ikat could be of two different types: warp ikat and weft ikat. If tie-dyed yarns are used in the warp way, then we call them as warp ikats. So in warp ikats, tie-dyed yarn is used for warp and a solid plain colored yarn is used for weft, whereas in weft ikats, the warp is solid and plain colored and the weft is tie-dyed. In both of these warp and weft ikats, the design could be seen either in the warp way or in the weft way. This is because of the colored yarns that are used. In double ikat, both the warp and the weft have tie-dyed patterns. So these yarns are tied according to the design on the graph paper, and once the dyeing is done, they are taken onto the loom and they are woven. So in double ikats, the design is a bit clear when compared to single ikats. In combined ikats, both the warp and weft are tie-dyed, but they are present in only in selected areas to create very interesting patterns. In India, the main production centers of ikat are in Gujarat, Orissa and the state of Telangana. Ikat in these different regions is known by different names, and each of these regions have their own characteristic motifs and patterns which are achieved by tie-dyeing. Ikats of Gujarat are called as patolas, whereas ikats of Orissa are called as bandhas, and in Telangana they are called as pochampally textiles. Another important textile that we can talk about today is Telia Rumal of Andhra Pradesh. Now, to begin with, let's discuss first about Patola. So the world famous Patola is from Pathan, place in Gujarat. This textile is considered to be very precious for a Gujarati bride. All the brides use this textile, and it is not only valued for its religious significance, but also the amazing level of skill and perseverance that is required to weave these designs. For that as well, this particular textile is valued. Both the warp and weft yarns are dyed in a particular design as envisaged by the master weaver, and then they are taken for weaving. Patola sarees are known for their colorful diversity and geometric style. Let us try to understand how this whole process takes place. The first step in making a patola is tying of yarn with cotton thread according to the pattern. This tying process is a very intricate and time consuming process. The tiers measure the yarn as per the design and then tie. So these measurements could be as small as 1/100th of an inch. Once the yarn is as per different designs, it undergoes different cycles of dyeing. dyeing usually happens from a lighter color and progresses on to a darker color. Say for example, you see blue, black, green and red colors in a tie-dyed yarn and yellow color as well. After tying, the dyeing starts from yellow color and then moves on to slowly darker shades, and then the last shade is the navy blue or the black one. So progression of dyeing happens from lighter shades to darker shades. The yarns have to be carefully arranged during dyeing and also after dyeing, because even the slightest displacement in any of the dyeing cycles will change the design or disturb the design arrangement. Not only just one thread, it disturbs the entire set of yarns that are used for weaving these patolas. After dyeing, the yarns are stretched out to make the warps. Only a master craftsman can handle this to do any repair and arrangement. The patola loom is quite different from the other looms in the fact that it is tilted to one side and it requires two people to finish the work. So two people sit together and weave one saree, and a small stick called as V is used to adjust the yarns in this particular loom. After a couple of inches of weaving, the weaver sees that the design is appropriate and tries to adjust the design using steel needles. Since the design is very intricate and precise, this particular portion of the design is checked by the weaver after weaving an inch or so. Patolas can be made both in cotton or in silk. If silk yarn is used, then a 8-ply yarn is used. Traditional weavers who do this weaving are known as salvis in Gujarat. The motifs of patola are Indian and very traditional. They consist of flowers, foliage, creepers, birds, animals, human figures and also geometrical figures. In the olden days, the colors were extracted from natural resources like different flowers and leaves and roots and barks and even some minerals as well. A very interesting feature of a patola is that it has no reverse side. Both the front and the back are same. There is no difference between the front side and the back side. Coming to the colors that are used to weave patolas, if you look at it, bright reds, oranges, yellows, greens and dark blues are also used. Brown is also quite commonly seen. The distinctive motifs that are used for patola weaving, like I said, are flowers, elephants, birds, and sometimes you can also see dancing women. If patolas are intended for the Muslim community, most of the patolas then are woven with abstract designs or geometric designs. The patola designs are named as Kunjar, Popat Bhat, which is an elephant parrot, Nari Kunjar Popat Bhat, which means a lady elephant and a parrot, Navaratan Bhat, which means a jewel mosaic, Phool Wali Bhat, which means a floral pattern, Chabri Bhat, which means a basket of flowers. So the elephant and tiger motifs are considered to be auspicious. The paan bat, which is the betel leaf, is one of the most frequent patterns that is used for making a patola. These expressive patola sarees are the prized possession for any Gujarati bride. They are used for their wedding occasions, and since it takes a very long time for two weavers to weave a saree, these sarees are very, very expensive. But at the same time, you are also having cheaper alternatives in the market which are available. So, the number of artisans practicing patola weaving is declining over the years owing to two reasons. One is the cost of the saree, and two, the cheaper alternatives that are easily available in the market. Now, let us see about bandas of Orissa. The tie-dye textiles or Ikat textiles of Orissa are known as bandas. It is a hand-woven saree and mainly made in Sambalpur town of Orissa. It uses both warp and weft tie-dyeing process. It is also produced in the neighboring districts of Sambalpur. The tie-dyeing of threads and weaving takes many weeks, and Sambalpuri double ikat weaving loom is called as tanta. It's an Orient word. The fabrics are called as Odisha ikat. The sarees first became popular outside the state when the late Prime Minister Mrs. Indira Gandhi started wearing them. In the 1980s and 1990s, they became very, very popular across the whole of India. Now let us see how the Sambalpuri double ikat weaving done. The designs are very traditional. They are crafted by traditional craftsmen. The Sambalpuri fabrics reflect an original style of craft known as banda, and the patterns include the flora and fauna, and sometimes even geometrical designs are also used. New types of banda depicting landscape and flower pots are also being designed nowadays. The yarns are tied as per the pattern drawn on the graph paper, and later they are dyed as per the color or colors envisaged. The yarns thus produced are called as banda. The unique feature of this form of design is that the designs are reflected almost identically on both sides of the fabric, just like patolas. So the front and the back of the fabric is same. Once the fabric is dyed, it can never be bleached in any other color. This versatile technique enables a craftsman to weave colorful designs, patterns and images into a fabric capable of giving meaning to a thought or conveying a message. The traditional motifs that are used in Odisha Ikat are Shankha, which is the conch shell, Chakra, which is the wheel, Phula, which is the flower, and Swastika as well. Other designs that are used are lotus flower, snake patterns, fish patterns, tortoise, and elephant motifs can also be seen. The Sambalpuri textiles today include furnishing materials, dress materials, and sarees as well. Sarees in silk and cotton, and even in mercerized cotton, can be seen in the market. They come in a variety of colors and in many different designs. The banda craftsmen are masters of the extra warp and extra weft style of designing, which can be seen in almost all forms of banda textiles. Satkapar sari is a traditional Sambalpuri sari. It is a double ikat checkered sari, and it has a weft brocaded border in Rudraksha pattern, and also sometimes fish can also be seen in the border. The pallu has bands of the floral motifs and figurative motifs, both of which are divided by narrow woven pattern lines. So essentially in a pallu you see pattern lines and in between some figured motifs. The government of India has tried to protect this art of weaving of Sambalpur, and it is included in the government of India's GI registry. The varieties of Sambalpuri sari include Sonipuri, Pasapalli, Bomkai, Barpalli, and Bapta sarees. These are all different kinds of Sambalpuri ikats which are very much in demand in the market. Now, let us talk about Pochampally ikats. Pochampally ikat is a variety of textile from a small village called Pochampally of Nalgonda district. It's in Telangana state. It is known for colorful silk sarees and dress materials woven in single ikat, mostly in geometric patterns. The sections of either warp or weft are tie-dyed. They are resisted first as per the design, and then they are dyed. So these resist dyed yarns are interlaced in a definite pattern. In that way you see the design on the fabric. The technique of ikat weaving and skill is believed to be brought to the town of Pochampally from Chirala of Andhra Pradesh, where it is locally called as Chitku. Besides Pochampally, Puttapaka, Koyalgudam and Chautupal villages in Telangana are producing ikat textiles. The fabric is cotton, silk, or sometimes seco, a mix of cotton and silk. One can see intricate geometric designs. These are unique to this particular town Pochampally town. It takes a family of four about 10 days to weave one sari. Its uniqueness lies in the transfer of intricate designs and coloring onto the warp and weft threads first, and then weaving them together into a double ikat design. Pochampally designs can be differentiated from their cousins in Orissa by their feel. Pochampally cloth is smoother when compared with the Odisha cloth. Odisha cloth is a bit heavy and flannelly as well. Pochampally ikat designs traditionally are diamond, chauka, diamond within a square. You can see a parrot, elephant and flower motif as well. The silk that is used to weave these particular textiles is brought from Bangalore, while the pure zari that is used for weaving these textiles is sourced from Surat. The weavers work for the cooperative society and the materials are provided to the weavers through these societies. The weavers are also working out on developing jacquard and dobby techniques to combine it with ikat with the help of Weaver Service Center, Hyderabad. Along with the traditional motifs, new designs are also being developed day by day, including the Patola designs. Pochampally sari is woven in Pochampally town. So Pochampally is a cluster of 80 to 100 villages having traditional looms whose pattern and designs are centuries old. Today, this silk city, which is more of a cottage industry, is home to more than 10,000 weaver families in 100 villages. The fabrics are marketed through these cooperative societies, many other linked organizations and boutiques. The Pochampally sari also received its GI status in 2005. Now, let us talk about Telia Rumal. So, it is a traditionally ikat textile originally produced in Chirala of Andhra Pradesh. Basically, it is a handkerchief which is square in shape and it is a rumal measuring about 1 meter square. Tel or oil is used as an important ingredient in the production. Hence, the name Telia Rumal has come. Padmasali community used to produce this Telia Rumal back in 19th century. These double ikat handkerchiefs were exported to the Middle East, Africa and Burma. In India, they are used as turbans by the fishermen. Sometimes they are also used as a lungi. The colors that are commonly used to weave this Telia Rumals are terracotta red, black and white colors, which at that point of time in the 19th century were derived from natural sources or natural dyes. The fabric was mainly cotton and it was modded with iron solution and alum. The original rumals had a geometrical grid-like pattern with borders all around. You could see dots, crosses and diamonds in the center of the rumal. Later on, flowers, birds and stars were included in the center of the rumal. As the demand declined for these rumals, the technique was adopted for other kinds of products like sarees and household textiles in the early 20th century. So the Pochampally weavers are using the same designs that were used to make Telia rumals, and they are now diversifying their craft into other products like sarees and household items. Viewers, let us now look at a silk saree, that is a Pochampally silk saree. This particular silk saree is dyed in red and white color. The body of the saree has this particular design spaced in regular intervals. If you look at this particular design, there are different colors: yellow, red, and then lemon yellow, mustard yellow and white as well. You also have a dark background as well, which is black in color. Now, to get this particular design, wherever you see the white portion, that particular portion is first resisted and then it is dyed in the lightest color, which is this lemon yellow color. Once this color is dyed and then resisted, the next color is taken up by the yarns, this particular mustard yellow color, and then later on the red color, and the last color would be the darkest color, which is black. So this particular design has to be first dyed in yarns, and then it is opened up and then just woven in this particular area. So this kind of motif requires lot of precision, and it is time consuming, and it is an intricate pattern, and it requires lot of skill on the part of the dyer and weaver. Viewers, let us now look at the pallu design of the saree. This silk saree has a red pallu. It has a checked pattern if you have a look at it. This particular box has a floral motif. This particular box has only small booties, and then this particular box has a floral motif again. The same floral motifs are repeated in this box way. So one box is filled up with motif, the other box is left blank, and then an alternate box is filled up. So this is the pallu design of silk saree. Today, we have learnt a lot about Patolas, Pochampally Ikats and Telia Rumals, Bandhas of Orissa as well.